All right, Marines. We are on foreign soil, boys. The biggest mistake you can make is not being prepared.
How bad is it?
We are completely overrun and held up in the safe room.
Keep it locked down until we get there?
Locked and loaded.
On me!
We're pinned down! Get away from the van!
This is my first action movie. And I think that's what drew me to it, is that I've always wanted to do not only an action movie, but the fact that he was a Marine was just doubled up on how badly I wanted to do it.
All the American embassies around the world, Marines are sent there to keep it safe if it hits the fan.
Lock it down!
It just tells the truth. It shines a nice light on our guys.
Not only do I have a whole lot more respect than I already did for our men and women in the military, but man, it's a tough world they go through.
Something that really drew me to this was the story. This is somebody who didn't know what he was getting himself into.
Oh, give me that. You're good and you know it.
This is a kid who knows he's good, thinks he's the best, but has never been in a real situation. And so when that happens, he has to change.
So I guess you were right.
So are you.
Anson, what's going on?
We got local backup coming in hot.
Couldn't time that better myself.
All right, go.
Go, go, go.
Ready?
Just try and keep up.
Okay, now tell us. Why did you join the Marines?
Why do you think? Because I red, white, and blue. My dad served, my papa before him. I'm a gunfighter raising a family of gunfighters.
Seriously, man? Come on. Tell us. I want the truth.
You can't handle the truth.
No, another bad impersonation of Jack Nicholson is what I can't handle. Come on, just tell us.
I joined the Marines to prove myself. I joined the Marines to be the best.
Gunny, go.
Hey, stall that. We got work to do.
These guys, they think of you as like this Marine Buddha.
What makes a great Marine? Just give us one thing.
You really want to know?
Yeah.
Hot fiber cereal.
I know that I've made some lifelong friends, and they're all gorgeous.
Oh, they're a good bunch of lads. A lot of Brits, some Americans, one Irishman.
We've all got very unique backgrounds and very unique perspectives on things, and the fact that we all mesh so well is nice.
It's part of the process, because if you don't have that, it's very hard to get a good movie.
This is the best part about embassy life. This right here, this is how you never leave home, no matter where you're at.
Gumbo's ready,
Gumbo.
Fellas. Come and get it.
Hashtag hoorah.
We've been laughing so hard throughout this entire shoot. The past month is just flown by.
On the one hand, it's great to be doing a film and it's exciting, but at the end of the day, what you take from it and what you remember it are the people you worked with and the fun you had doing it.
I've been following William Kaufman's career, the director. I've always wanted to work with him.
Will's good. He's, easygoing, very collaborative.
He's ex-military. He brings that eye and that expertise to it.
He's a great director, a great guy, and to take on the challenge of shooting a movie this big in the amount of time that we've done it, I just don't know how he did it.
Back up!
These are all young newcomers, and they represented well, you know, and we got a chance to go out and, party a little bit, get to know each other.
Dennis comes on the set, and he just has that presence.
They're gonna get an ass full now.
Everyone turns and stands at attention, and I'm not in the military, I'm like, sir, yes, sir.
Roger that.
It was really great on a lot of levels. One, because I'm so familiar with his work, but also because I'm a fan. Ever since I was a kid, Major League was one of my favorite movies, and he was Pedro Serrano, and I loved him. And it's been really cool not just to work with him, but to hang out with him. He's a great guy.
At ease, Marie.
Charlie's good. He looks like a jarhead.
Die Hard originated from the failed script of Commando 2. For this and more movie facts, click on more videos. But if you want something else, click on the playlist.